welcome to Tawasal Expo, Rasso.
Thank you. It's nice to be here. Very excited.
Rasso, when we talk about Al Masaood Power Division partnering with Expo, it's just a continuation of an endless collab that you have with the government and in particular with DEWA. This time, it's a bit different though. You're energizing and lighting up the Expo for 6 months. How does this empower and position Al Masaood in general and Al Masaood Power Division?
Yeah, I mean, we are not directly powering the Expo 2020, but through DEWA, we are part of it to make sure that the Expo functions properly and it continues having energy wherever they need and whenever they need. We have delivered a couple of units, which I believe we'll talk about later, to make sure that the Expo is a successful event, it stays safe, and it has always the energy it needs. And opportunity, sustainability, mobility is a big part of it. And for everything, you need energy, and we are there to supply, or to support, to supply.
When we talk about Al Masaood Power Division, we obviously talk about electricity and power. But I think partnering with Expo is a bit more innovative, at least as we speak now. I mean, you have 13 mobile generators on trucks. You'll tell us a bit about that. But how was this possible? Was it hard? What were the efforts deployed in order to achieve this?
Yeah. DEWA or Expo 2020, obviously has a big requirement and very difficult requirements to fulfill. So we have designed for this, particularly for this project, mobile generators. It's a mobile power solution. It's built on a truck.
Is it the first time that you use these mobile generators?
It's not the first time that mobile generators are getting used. However, it's the first time a mobile generator in this size, in this capacity, is actually built here and is deployed through DEWA to the Expo 2020 Dubai. Yeah. So with having these trucks here, there was a big requirement, obviously, on the capacity. So this truck we have delivered with the power solution on top of it is most probably the biggest in the size in the region. It was the first time delivered to DEWA, and it was in cooperation with DEWA designed, produced here in the UAE, and then handed over, commissioned, and now it's in use. The size of it is 2,000 kilowatt electric, so you can basically power around 400 residential units with it. So it's a very big, product. And here, what are the challenges? Is one of them is obviously the requirements of the RTA. So the truck needs to be completely roadworthy. It needs to be within the limits of the size. It needs to be within the limits of the weight. And on top of it, the requirements of DEWA is to operate this generator for 8 hours minimum to make sure that it is a continuous backup power for the grid or for the network where it's required.
I'm really curious to know, where are these trucks and mobile generators? Yeah. We don't see them, obviously.
You will not see them. They're feeding from let's say, feeding stations. So they're not standing around here during the Expo, but there are points around the Expo where they come and feed when it's required.
What were the challenges in achieving this?
Yeah, the challenges here in achieving was the short period of time. So the design, ordering, delivering was 11 months. So this was one of the challenges. The challenges here, the requirements, as I mentioned before, the RTA, the roadworthiness of the truck, and the big, huge power demand requirement put on this truck to have everything in one package. So basically, you could take this truck, you drive it anywhere you want, you feed it into the grid, and you light up whatever needs to be lit up. So that was these are the major challenges.
Did you have enough time to test these mobile generators?
We had enough, obviously the time was enough to test it, and they have been tested substantially in terms of time and on capacity. However, we have a really good team who managed to do it in 11 months. And very happy to have this delivered to DEWA. And hopefully DEWA is also, satisfied with our work and with our product we have delivered.
Partnering with Expo was not the only thing that Al Masaood Power Division did inside the Expo. You participated in showcasing the propulsion engines in the Sea Trade Maritime Middle East 2021. Tell us a bit about that.
Yes, we had the Sea Trade 2021 you just mentioned, which has actually been here happening in the Expo Center itself, so Expo Center South at Expo 2020 Dubai. And here we had a stand representing our three brands, MTU, Volvo Penta, and Lillard-Sermet. And on the stand itself, we had, let's say, the existing products which are developing in terms of emission new requirements. However, we also had a hybrid system launched, which was the first time here in the UAE. It's a hybrid system which was designed, built, and put together here in the UAE.
You showcased the hybrid engines inside the Expo for the first time in UAE.
Yes, right? we did. So it's not the engine, it's a complete system. So it's a boat which is running on electric power, battery driven, diesel power supported, as well as can be charged as an electric vehicle on the shore. And this was here first time launched last week during SeaTrade 2020. On top of it, we had another, let's say, new developments in terms of new version of engines. We talked about the strategy in terms of hybrid, in terms of hydrogen, fuel cell, what is coming up, not the next 2-3 years, but it will come the next 5 to 10 years. So a lot of things were happening during the Expo 2020 Dubai. And we are, I would say, taking part of this exhibition since many years. And we particularly were very proud to be at Expo 2020 Dubai during this exhibition.
Obviously, I mean, you embraced well, even during the SeaTrade Maritime, the theme of sustainability in the Expo, through the hybrid engines.
So here...
Systems.
Here it's very important that the sustainability is one part of it. Mobility is the other part, right? We talked about maritime. We talked about the mobile generator, so there's a mobility coming with it. On the other hand, there's opportunities. Sustainability means change. Sustainability means also long-term change, good change. And here, very important is that, let's say, in the DNA of our company, Masaood, we are existing now since 50 years, or last year it was 50 years.
Golden Jubilee.
The Golden Jubilee as the UAE this year. And a part of our DNA as the company DNA is to make sure that the company is supporting the government wherever it's required. And that means also in long-term strategies to be involved, to support wherever it's required, and to bring new technologies that the company can help the government to evolve.
I mean, when I'm going to say that again. You're lighting up the Expo. You're energizing the Expo for 6 months, and yet a mainstream visitor would only know that there's light and electricity, and probably would know that this is coming through DEWA. Well, it is coming through DEWA, but don't you think that you need to have more merit when it comes to Al Masaood Power Division in particular?
Yes, we are working on consumer goods. So typically in our industry, it's a B2B, let's say, partnership. We have businesses to businesses. We are sharing parts of their business. Obviously, we support them in certain areas. However, it becomes, with terms of mobility, more and more obvious that the opportunity lies in the B2C business. And here we talk about mobility. So mobility is required. Electric cars are getting, let's say, deployed more and more.
Yeah.
Governments are requesting for a sustainable mobility part, which means that more and more e-vehicles has to be used. Some governments, especially in Europe now, they're promoting to buy e-vehicles. That has to come here as well, and it will come here. However, somebody or something needs to electrify this or charge this e-vehicles, and there's still a shortage on it. So if you're in the middle of the desert with an e-vehicle, you cannot charge it, right?
So in here we're talking more about B2C products, which is probably the launch of a new series of consumer products.
Yeah. So, I mean, electric vehicle charging is nothing new. What is, let's say, here new for us is the complete solution for it. So you as a building owner, or you as a electric vehicle owner, you can actually buy now a charging system which is self-sufficient, self-sustaining. So it means it could be anywhere in the world. It could be at the beach, it could be in the middle of the desert, it could be somewhere in the wadis, wherever it's required. That's a solution you put there, and you can charge whatever you need. That does not mean only an electric vehicle. It could be also on the beach a boat, or whatever is required to charge.
How does it work, this e-charger?
The e-charger itself is a simple conversion of electricity into another electricity, which then goes into the vehicle in a simple term. However, the problem here is somebody or something needs to power this electric vehicle charger. And here we have a solution through battery power, through solar panels, solar energy. And this as a combination could be completely off-grid. That means you can really have it in your car park at home without using the power from the grid. Or if there's no power, you can actually use this, let's say, saved electricity also to power your house.
Is it the same as the concept of the power bank for the mobile charger?
Yeah, it is a similar concept. It's a battery storage or it's an electricity storage. You have a source of electricity, which is either solar or other means of energy, and you combine this together, and then you can charge your vehicle without being connected to the grid.
I think with this product, and hopefully with more products to come directed to the consumer, you will need to communicate differently, especially with the consumer. Do you have any idea how you will be communicating with the consumer directly?
Yeah.
As Al Masaood, which is not happening now?
No, it's not happening right now. You're absolutely right. And here, the let's say, our industry marketing directions are not built for B2C. So we are now looking into using this B2C or, let's say, other means of marketing to develop and to create these marketing campaigns. It is a challenge for us, as it is not our core, let's say, marketing strategy. But I think Expo 2020 Dubai, talking about sustainable energy, talking about sustainable life in general, mobility is a big part, and you can see all the little robots running around
here.
So it becomes more and more mainstream to talk about energy, and that also supports us in our marketing strategy in future for this B2C products.
I'm going to say this and keep on repeating that you guys are energizing the Expo for 6 months. I mean, you're bringing life to Expo. But this is really like raising the bar super high. Any project that has to come after that has to be, I mean, at least comparable with the biggest expo in the world, which is Expo 2020. What's next in the pipeline?
Yeah, I mean, looking at Expo 2020 Dubai in general and having the concept of connecting minds, connecting ideas, that means in connection to today's
building
life.
Building the future.
Building the future, and it's built on data. So data has to be stored somewhere. So data center is a very, very big, let's say, thing in the moment in the industry, to build data centers, to protect data, to store data, and obviously to get connected around the world. So our next or our big, let's say, follow-on projects from here, Expo 2020 Dubai, is investing in data centers. Means building in on a sustainable future. Obviously, a data center is not built for 1 year, 2 years, whatever. They have a very long, let's say, depreciation. So they need to build, be built in a sustainable way. So data centers is one of the future projects in terms of size. On the other hand, sustainability, we are working on projects in terms of biogas, we are working waste to energy, so making out of waste energy which you can consume in your building. So that's another big thing. So sustainability and being part of, let's say, the connectivity is a big part of our strategy in future.
So we've been talking about Al Masaood Power Division and Expo and the partnership, but I'm really curious about a story that pertains to you during your career. It could be Al Masaood, it could be before, anything that taught you the hard way, something in this, in your career.
Yeah, I think one of the things which taught me a lesson, and it took some time to accept it, is to accept mistakes. We talk about so many changes happening in the country here. We talk about new things coming up in no time. So there will be mistakes, but to accept mistakes, learn out of mistakes, recognize them in a timely manner, and accept that it's happening and, you know, change it for the future. That's a big thing, which is a challenge for me. And I think that's what I always remember: accepting mistakes, don't do them again, change them in the future. But you still have to make them to learn out of it, and that makes you grow.
Rasso, so you want to embrace failures and mistakes and you learn from them. Now you're going to tell me about a mistake that you learned from.
I mean, it's a different culture here than where I come from, right? And I try to be as open as I can be where I come from. It always, does not always work within here, so that was one of my, let's say, learning curve to accept other cultures, which went very quickly, but that's one thing which I take away from working and living in the Middle East, to accept different cultures, to live with different cultures, and to get on with it.
Rasso, thank you very much for having you today at Tawassal Expo. We really learned a lot, about energizing the Expo and about upcoming projects. We hope to see you in coming episodes. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, and thank you for having me.